What happens when your phone stops working and everything seems lost? Today, we're going to find out with a real case. One of those that technicians love because they reveal much more than you'd imagine. In this video, we won't just learn how to identify a fault, but also the key tools we use in the step-by-step process to diagnose and repair a device. Let's get to it. First, we identify the fault using a tool that measures electrical consumption. This is where the process starts to reveal clues. As you can see, even the recording program stopped when we connected the charging cable, which clearly indicates that the device is short-circuited. For technicians, these cases are among the most interesting because they allow us to quickly pinpoint the root of the problem. To access the motherboard, the first step is to remove the back cover. We heat the surface with a heat gun to loosen the adhesive and then use a metal pick to create a small gap. To make this process easier, we apply contact cleaner, a trick that always helps smooth things out. This step requires precision, but it doesn't take long since we want to get straight to the issue. Once the device is disassembled, we find a design typical of many phones. At the top is the motherboard with the cameras. In the middle is the battery, and at the bottom is the charging module and speaker. Interestingly, this plastic support not only protects but also doubles as an antenna, showcasing how optimized these designs are. If you're just starting in the world of repairs, here's a fundamental tip. Before touching any component, always disconnect the battery connector. This is essential to avoid further damage. The causes of these types of faults can vary. Impacts, moisture, overheating, poorly optimized updates, or even the infamous planned obsolescence we all know. Now we focus on the flex bridge, which is responsible for transmitting power, data, and signals from the bottom of the phone to the motherboard. To inspect it, we use a microscope to look for cracks or damaged connections in the connectors. This flex is a critical component, and any damage can lead to serious issues. Technicians use a laboratory power supply to diagnose electronic problems. We connect this tool directly to the battery flex, allowing us to simulate an external battery while monitoring real-time consumption. This helps us understand whether the device has a normal power cycle or is consuming energy incorrectly. In our case, the device turns on, but if it didn't, this tool would be crucial for identifying potential faults. As you can see, the motherboard and screen are in good condition, which implies the issue lies below the motherboard. It could be the flex bridge or the charging module. Finally, we identified the culprit. The flex bridge is short-circuited. This type of flex contains very thin traces, and in this case, some of them had merged, causing the fault. These repairs may seem simple, but they're complex and require specific tools. If you don't have these tools, it's best to visit a nearby specialized workshop to ensure the job is done properly. As you've seen, even a seemingly small fault can pose a significant technical challenge. But with the right tools and an accurate diagnosis, it can be solved. These repairs are a way to extend the lifespan of devices and prevent them from becoming electronic waste. I hope this video has been helpful and that you've learned something new about the fascinating world of repairs. My name is Leonardo, and on this channel, you'll find more cases like this. practical advice, and technical analyses. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with someone who might find it useful. See you in the next video. Best regards.